So the gas card skimmers have been a problem with several of the counties that surround Collar County. And our commissioners wanted to get ahead of the game and make sure that we had something in place to be able to not have that happen in Collier. In December, we had a draft of the ordinance that came into effect on January 1st, 2019, and it was to have the fuel pumps have some type of a security requirement so that gas skimmers could be prevented from being put into each of the fuel pumps. Yeah, historically, most of the fuel pumps have a generic key, kind of what they call like a golf cart key. So one key could open multiple gas stations, which then allows the criminals that are putting in the skimmers to be able to easily open these fuel pumps, install the skimmer, and then that skimmer will gather all of that credit card information. And the next thing you know, you end up getting charges on your credit card that you have no idea where they came from. We started going out to each gas station and prior to the ordinance coming into effect and doing a meet and greet, educating them, providing a brochure as to what information and requirements were going to be in the ordinance that came into effect on January 1st.
All right, well, when we go out to inspect the pump, we're looking for one of three things at the fuel pump. One is whether they have a locking mechanism that's unique to the store or the premise itself. Then we actually inspect the pump. We open it up. The pump needs to have one of two other things. Either A, when you open the pump, it has to have an anti-breach system where it shuts down. So it completely shuts the pump down so you can't use it at all. It actually sends out an alarm to the clerk inside that, hey, something's going on with this pump. The third one we're looking for, if they don't have the anti-breach or the aftermarket lock, is what they call an encryption system. A lot of your newer gas stations all have what they call the encryption system. And that's where when you use your credit card, it jumbles the information. So therefore, if a skimmer is trying to access that, he's getting nothing but a bunch of jumble. It's real easy to come into compliance, but if they don't, then there are ramifications that kick in afterwards, and so we can deal with the process of bringing them into compliance.
The public can contact code enforcement at any time that they feel there is a fuel pump that may have been breached. If they think that there is something strange going on with the pump, or you know, they can always advise the manager inside. Pay inside is also an option if they ever feel uncomfortable with the pump that outside, or contact code enforcement absolutely, so that we can take a look at it.